Welcome to Heart Affairs Channels. We are meeting today Soni, the young, pretty, 25 years old girl who has undergone a mitral valve replacement surgery at Leelavati Hospital by Dr.pavan 5th May 2015. And we are going to know about the management of anticoagulation after mitral valve surgery from her. Hi Soni.
Hi Vida. Thanks a lot for saying so many beautiful things about me. Everyone, my name is Soni and I am 29 years old right now. And I work in TCS as a senior finance analyst. And I went through mechanical valve heart surgery 4 years back. So I'm just going to tell you my experience regarding how I met and how this surgery is helping me away a lot from my previous.
So you know, how you came to know about your heart valve problem?
Actually, it happened in the Sunday night. I was out. I didn't have anything. I just had my dinner at night. And suddenly, I don't know why, I was having some acidity problem. Because of which I came to know I was feeling breathless. So I did my ECG. And during ECG, I came to know that I was having abnormal heart rates. So like that, I came to know that it was acidity that time. But after that, I came to know after doing Turico that I was having a heart problem also, which my mitral valve was not working properly, because of which my heart was getting increased, heart size.
So how did you meet Dr. Pavan Kumar?
So it is a blessing that I met Pavan Kumar sir. It is. I never thought. We went to many hospitals, and after that also we went to other doctors to confirm whether it is true or not. Because in such a young age, not having any kind of problem before, suddenly heart problem like it.
Yeah.
People are not going to believe that, right? Family also didn't believe. But then going to other cardiologists and everything, I came to know that it is a heart problem. So after going to many hospitals, going to many cardiologists, going to many cardiosurgeons, one of the best doctor I found out was Pavan Kumar sir through one of my brother's friend, because he also got operated from this doctor.
Great.
But when I met Dr. Pavan Kumar sir, it was like I'm meeting my family only. He was just so cool, so calm, and so much. He kept me so comfortable for this surgery thing, because my family got shocked first of all listening to this heart surgery. Then after listening to him, it was like, no, it is just, I have to be a little brave, which I was. And so this only I can
And
to
you
know
finally undergone mitral
yes,
valve heart
after
surgery.
After having a conversation with him, it was so light. He just made me feel so comfortable, and he just said, it is okay, it happens, it is nothing. And after listening to him, I found out that it is nothing, it is common, it's just a few days management that I have to do. Because heart surgery, heart is a very important organ of our body, and heart and brain, if you can understand. If anything happens to these two organs, that it completely, body ko ekdum damage kar deta hai. So I was little scared, but not that much. But after meeting him, having a conversation with him, I found out that it is not that much difficult, but I have to manage, which I did.
Tell us about after operation, do you have to take any precautions, any do's and don'ts?
Yes, precautions, yes, of course I have to take. First of all, he advised me, because doctor told me to have a valve replacement surgery. So I was a bit, I was not having any idea which valve to replace, like mechanical valve or tissue valve. Valves which generally people, doctor recommend.
So you have research, right?
Yes, I do research it. Why? Because see, at a young age, I have to be very, very careful, because I have a long life to live. Research, and after asking doctor also, he only told me there are, like, instead of doing tissue valve, it's better to do mechanical valve. Why? Because mechanical valve are like, they are very much better for a long duration. Why? Actual tissue valve, as in when you do tissue valve surgery, it takes around after 10 years it becomes, because it's an organ, right?
Yeah.
It is. There are also chances that organ is going to get affected by anything or the other.
Mm.
But as far as mechanical valve is concerned, it is a metal, so it only two precautions need to be taken for that. Because in mechanical valve or in tissue valve, what happens in mechanical valve, I have to make my blood thin.
Yeah.
Why? In order to
keep it thin.
Keep the anticoagulation.
Okay.
So I have to take blood thinner. So I went to this instead of a tissue wall, I went for this mechanical wall, which is a very beneficial wall. Why? Because it has a longer life. It is for lifetime. So mechanical wall. Talking about mechanical wall, yes, there is a little bit of noise which happens, but yes, it is very much comfortable after a few days. And precautions which I take generally, I go to the doctors. I do the regular checkup for my anticoagulation, because when it is exposed, when my blood exposed to the sun, it gets blood. It gets affected.
Yes. So after mitral valve replacement of this mechanical valve, do you have to take any medication? We are going to talk about your anticoagulation management.
Yes.
So
yes.
You tell us about that.
Yeah, I do. Mechanical valve. Actually, I am very proud to take this mechanical valve replacement surgery.
Great.
And yes, for anticoagulation, I do regular checkups. I have to take medicine, blood thinner. Why? Because my blood as of now, it has to be thin as compared to the normal person. Twice a level. Why? Because for passing the blood, it has to be a little thin so that blockages can be avoided. And since 4 years, I'm not facing any kind of problem after taking all these medicines. I need to go to the lab and do the regular checkups quarterly, and come to doctor and ask him about everything. What is it? I do 2D echo, and apart from that, I do ECG and I do prothrombin test, which is nothing but internationalized normalized ratio, which has to be between 2 to 3, which is mine generally. Today also I came for that only. So these two precautions I need to take, and apart from that, I should not get any cut or bleed. Why? Because it will be a little bit of difficult to manage right now, as my blood is a little bit thin. So yes, I do that.
Do you take any particular medicine?
Yes, I do take a morph medicine. It's a blood thinner, and generally every day 6 in the evening. There should be a particular time for it so that the blood thin level will be managed properly.
Okay.
That is the thing.
Great. So these are all the do's and don'ts to how to take care
not to get infection, not to get fever. Yes. I am supposed to be, you know, not to get fever, which I generally do. I should avoid outside food also, which I generally do, so that I should not get any diseases. These little bit precautions has helped me since 4 years to live a healthier life than before. And I go to office, I do my general work, and I play around with my friends, and also do multiple activities. I am still, after surgery, I am not having any kind of issues. Which I was having previously before, like headache or something like that. But right now, life has been very much comfortable for me. Yes, you have to manage a little bit at the initial stage, because surgery, it's a heart surgery, so you have to manage. And it is easy. It is not at all difficult. And once you manage it, you will understand and you will know only a little bit of management is required. And apart from that, once the 1 month and 2 months duration is turned up, ended, life will be simple and life will be very much easier than before. And it is. Thanks to Dr. Pavan sir.
Thank you very much, Soni.
Yes.
You have given us a very educational and very, very important information.
Okay.
How to take care of our anticoagulation after the mitral valve surgery. So take home messages from Heart Affairs channels today is not to get afraid. Whenever, if you get any heart valve disease in your heart, do all the checkups like 2D echo, 2D extra chest, show to your doctor, and take a wise decision. Thank you.
Thank you.